Oh, we need to distract him with another one. Hey bud, how about a Kong that's already in the process of being destroyed?
How about that?
Give him two.
Like a year.
Well, that's what they originally said, and then
I'd give him two tops.
So, okay, Pepper. Let's try this. Wow, am I in the right place? You know,
I wonder if she was like, what if it's related to her at all?
Well, I've been, so interestingly enough, I've been getting spam with texts and phone calls from her, multiple numbers.
Okay.
And each time I get a new one, I block it, and I will get money, so I was telling, I saw Debbie, we were talking about it outside. And I said, you know what?
Let me copy and paste this and see if it shows up on, it's 520-790-4616.
Because I went back and looked at when I started. Yeah, when I first started doing, when I had to start blocking these numbers, and it was literally 2 days after I sent that email, is when the first number started showing up. So now there's four different phone numbers. She works in IT, so like.
Oh, you know, she can do, she can do all kinds of stuff. She could have all kinds of different phone numbers. Oh, you just Google this number and see if it comes up. I didn't do it, but I'm like, who's calling me? And I'm not picking up if I don't know who you are. And leave a message if it's important. I'll call you back. She hasn't contacted me since I made it clear to her to contact.
Well, I suspect that she has been down this road before.
Team Bonnie Leo? Leon?
Leo?
Yeah,
Leon.
Leo? And just back off.
I really think that she has done this before.
Yeah.
And she knows exactly what she can do legally and she because I connect with everybody that I talk to about this is like you need to do it. For what reason? On what basis? She's not calling me, she's not texting me, she's not emailing me, she's not showing up at my door.
Right.
She's not breaking any laws.
Right.
She's harassing the shit out of PACC, but Katie told her the last time she was there this past week, Katie told her, she said, don't come in here asking about this dog again. The notes have been put in about on the dog and on your records. Don't come in here again. He's not leaving here with you under any circumstances. So, and now it's
barring her from it. Like,
well, that's what Kelly said, that if she they've decided now that if she comes in one more time, after, because now she's been told by a manager, by someone with the credentials to say what Katie said,
right?
That now if she comes back and tries it again, then they will tell her that she's no longer welcome to PACC and that she shows up again, she'll be trespassing. And then they can do something. So it'll be a third time.
Right.
You know? But I suspect, I'm right there with you, that she's mentally ill.
Yeah.
And I think she's done this before. I think she knows what she can get away with and what she can't.
Yeah. She's stalked before. She's done.
Freaking crazy. And I told him, I said,
God.
He came home from the store. She was here for 3 hours with him. He came home from the store for the first time in months. He had eyes.
Yeah.
And within 2 hours of being home, they were gone. By the time you and I got off the phone that night, they were gone.
Yeah.
I always thought the whole time he was with her and he would come up here, Brian and I talked about it a bunch of times. I always figured it was that damn grass where she lives.
Yeah.
But he wasn't anywhere near grass that day when he was here. The only thing that was different in that whole 24 hours with her was when she was here with him for those 2 hours. And she never got.
She was glued to him.
Yep. And in hindsight, the best thing you could have done was to go for that walk with her, because I think she would have left
you. Yeah.
I really truly do.
I mean, I shut down when she took him and left. Like, it was like, I'm like, and I'm waiting for you to say something.
Well,
because, like,
well, you were right
something?
There, so I just assumed
and
that you guys were going
we get outside, and as we're walking, I'm like, I gotta watch this. She could take him. She's like, I got him, I got him. I'm like,
no,
I'm staying with you.
Just walk my dogs in my neighborhood. I don't know what she's capable of.
Yeah, I know.
That's kind of crazy.
She's doing stalking through PACC, essentially.
Well, and she probably has no idea that I know about all of these.
Yeah.
And the only reason that they put all the pieces together is because, I, like I said, the innocent, that innocent phone call that the volunteer made to me this past week is what became the catalyst for all of this other stuff to come out, because I was pissed and I got in touch with Kelly, who went over and talked to Julianne, and while Julianne was on the phone with me, they was in her office and covered it. And that's how we told everything together. So come to find out, there's five different instances that they knew of. So Katie went in and she read the email, I put it on his notes. I have a restricted note for the first batches, and I've also put it on her PID information under notes with a flag, so that if she comes in and they pull up anything, both his record and hers have been flagged.
Yeah, I think it's kind of like what we were talking about. She put her feelings for her mom onto him, and I'm not condoning what she's done, but
I get why your girlfriend.
She wants
what she wants, when she wants, how she wants it,
and nobody's gonna tell her otherwise.
Yeah, exactly.
But if it's not, you know, some kind of crazy thing, then it's, some people need that.
Yeah.
She started going to PACC. I guess she figured, right, I'm not going to call. I'm not going to talk to your person. Hey, there's literally like five people at PACC that even have to call you or anything, and none of them are the average person that you live in there. You have to know who to talk to in order to get to that level.
She's got a
Priya would have just gotten along with Leo. None of this would have ever happened. So you could just tell Priya.
I'll go home and I'll tell Priya and she'll just go.
And she'll be like, so it caused a problem for Bonnie? Good.
And really, it's your fault because you're the one who said, you know, she's going to be a bee now. She's not going to be able to come back to the store. You know, this will be your last drive with me.
I think she's intelligent enough to know
Like you said, she's done this before.
She knows what's gonna happen. That's why I think she hasn't come back.
Yeah.
I really do.
Yeah.
She knows what'll happen.
She's been down this road before.
Yeah.
Oh, she, what about her?
Yep.
That's something, she likes the, she's a girl.
I was gonna say, it's so nice and quiet, then I realized.
All of our dogs.
She's busy with John, and the other three are four, are all out. We literally have two dogs in here right now. Now that she has settled in here, oh yeah, that cute little thing for Thursday. Boy, John, you should be glad you weren't here on Thursday.
Trouble?
Holy hell, we had this dog called Drax. To say that this dog is shit crazy doesn't even begin to cover it.
Boy.
Completely insane.
Oosh.
Door darter, pushed everybody out of the way, and as soon as he'd come out, he'd totally come over here and start.